Hello and welcome students. This is I, Anand Kumar Verma, and you are watching Agriculture with Anand. Today I am going to tell you about functional organization of cell. Before starting elaboration of this topic, I would very much like to thank my introduction to biology professor Dr. Abhishek Kumar Verma sir, who inspired me to do so. Okay, let's go. Now we are going to know the introductory part of cell biology. So all living organisms are made out of cells. As we all know, cells are the smallest living unit and also a functional unit. Okay, as you say, the human egg, cell and sperm. And history, we are going to know the history of this. Okay, Robert Hooke in 1665 first discovered and named cell, looked at dead cells of a cork plant. This is important phenomena that he looked at dead cells of a cork plant. Okay, then next, Anton von Leeuwenhoek 1674 built cell microscope to study animalcules. It means animal-like structure known today as microorganisms. First to see living cells. Anton von Leeuwenhoek, who see living cells. And after that, cell theory, Matthias Leiden, 1838, stated all plants are made of cells. And after that, Theodore Swan, 1839, studied human notochord, it means the spinal cord, concluded all animals are made of cells. And after that, Rudolf Virchow, 1858, every cell comes from another cell like it. It means every cell had its origin and it was the same like the previous cell. And after that, modern cell theory promotes that all living things are composed of cells and cells are unit of structure and function in living things except viruses, because viruses has no cells, they have RNAs only. And after that, new cells are produced from pre-existing cells, as per Virchow said. And intro into cell biology. Single cell organisms, such as multi-cell organisms. Single cell organisms, such as known as microorganism. In single cell organisms, there will be only single cell. In multi-cell organisms, there will be multiple cells. Okay, such as single cell organisms, such as bacteria, arachia, yeast and fungi. Okay, introduction, intro into cell biology. Multi-cell organisms, higher degree or organizations of cells within the organisms. Example as human red blood cells, human skin cells, plant cells and etc. Okay, the type of cell. All cells from any of the five kingdom, Monera, Protista, Plantae, Fungi and Animalia, are either prokaryotic cells or eukaryotic cells, as we all know. Okay, intro into cell biology. Prokaryotic, it means dormant bacteria. Single cell organisms, prokaryotic cells, it means they will contain a single cell. And after that, no nucleus, there will be no nucleus and no compartments. Basically, in prokaryotics or prokaryon bacteria, they have only single cells with no nucleus and no their compartments. Okay, then peptidiclone cells walls, and after that, binary fissions for energy. Use organic chemicals, inorganic chemicals are photosynthesis, as you can see in the picture. Okay, in prokaryotic, domain arachia, like a peptidiclone, live in extreme environments such as extreme temperatures, includes methanogens and extreme halophiles, extreme thermophiles means thermal living species, such as you can say the high temperature loving species. Okay, then thermophile, extreme means high level of temperature. And after that, role in disease not well understood. This group has only recently been discovered. Okay, this is not totally elaborated in any form. Okay then, domain eukaryotic. Planty, multicellular plants, cellulose cell wall, photosynthesis. Okay, fungi, chitin cell walls, use of organic chemicals for energy. It means these plants or fungi works with organic chemicals to make energy. Mold and mushrooms are multicellular consisting of masses of mycelia, which are composed of filament called hyphae. Protistas, protozoa, motile via pseudomonas, pseudopodas, cilia or flagella, algae and photosynthetics. Animalia, multicellular animals, parasitic flatworms and roundworms are called helminthes, microscopic stages in life cycle. You cannot see these things without any microscopes. Okay, we are going to elaborate every single compartment of cell. First, plasma membrane or cellular membrane. As you can see in the picture, plasma membrane is the outer boundary of this cell. Separates the cytoplasm from the extracellular fluid outside of the cell, as you know that. And we are going to know the functions of cell membrane. Protects the cell. Okay, we know that plasma membrane protects the whole cells from the other foreign infections. Second, controls but enters and leaves the cells. Okay, now next, plasma membrane is selectively permeable. It means it can pass some things. Okay, so only certain things can pass through, as you can see in the pictures. Okay, transportation. As you know that the several things pass through the cell membrane, such as you can see in this picture, there will be a protein channel and the inside cells and the other phenomena, such as here is the outside cell and here is the inside cell. Well, I cannot present this type of things in this type of presentation. Okay then, cytoplasm. Next, what is the cytoplasm? It is the constituent of inside of the cell. Second, cytoplasm consists of cellular structures such as organelles and the systole. What is systole? A thick soap of salt. A thick soup of salt. Organic molecules and enzymes for reactions. It contains some enzymes for the reaction. Okay then, next, makes up 70% of cell. Okay then, our next topic is cell wall, only found in plants. It's an exception. A structure, rigid wall made of cellulose. Fibers of cellulose are interlocked, leaving spaces. Okay, it contains several spaces and it's make a interlocked like structure, as you can see in the picture. Now, next, cell wall, completely permeable. Allows any small thing to pass through freely, passes through spaces in the cell wall. What is the function of the cell wall? Protection from physical injuries, and second, provides support in the conjunction with the vascules. Okay, next, the nucleus, one of the most important phenomena, found in all eukaryotic, one per cell. It means a cell contain a nucleus. Okay, a complex organelle structure having its own membrane. Brain of the cell. It is also known as the brain of the cell, which regulates the cell activities, such as contains cell's DNA. It means it has its only, it has its own DNA. Okay, as you see in the pictures. Nucleus structures, nuclear envelope, nucleoplasm, nucleus, chromatins. Well, now I am the 24th slide, and in this presentation I have 42 slide, and I have not enough time to produce all matter in one video, and I have not enough data to upload it. Well, this is enough for today. I'll make another video on the same topic. Well, have a nice day. Thank you so much.